As a matter of fact, you and Samuel Jackson celebrated your 40th wedding anniversary just a little bit ago. And how do you keep the music playing? How do you make it last?
Oh, listen to you. Just make that song. Play that song, too. Play that next.
Exactly.
oh, God, I don't know. We thank God for living, you know. Put God first and try to follow the tenets that he sets forth, that a universe has set forth, to live in peace, because that's all it is. It's just trying to figure out how to live in peace, which is why I'm so concerned about this republic we live in right now. I'm like, all these people that we have put in place and we can't figure out how to live in peace, it's not even a one-on-one. It's a group in a group.
Yeah.
Surely there must be some way to reach somebody across the aisle, as they say. Mm. So for me and my husband, we forgive a lot. We don't really forget, but we try to put it on a shelf that's not like an everyday remembrance. But to forgive and amnesia, move on.
And there you go. But one of the things I really love is, one, the opening night of The Killer Mockingbird, I was right across from him. And when, because every time you came onto the set, the people were just loved you. And I remember looking over at him when you took your bow. And baby, the way he was beaming at his bride. When I tell you the pride that he had in you being on that stage and slaying it, it was so beautiful. Do you guys ever go through those battles of like being jealous? Because, you know, a lot of artists that are married to other artists, sometimes it's that like envy or that jealousy or whatever. Did you guys ever have to tackle that?
We still do. We're tackling it now with all of these interviews that we are called to do for Enslaved. That's why, you know, I told the publicist that now, you know, he's the star. I'm a blue collar worker, so
right.
I know my place. And even though I said I can be more loquacious than Sam on any given day, I said let him have it because he's going to take over. He will take over, you know. Mm-hmm. And so it's like it's not a jealousy or envy, but I do clock it. It's like listen. On one interview we just finished, we were talking, and the guy kept saying, So Sam, because everybody, Sam is on first, I get it. But if you got both of us on a call for an interview, you do have to go to me at some point. And I hung the phone up. And at the end of the interview, Sam said, that guy said, Miss Jackson, and I told him, oh, she hung up a long time ago.
I love it. You know what? That was just stupidity on his part. So when you're dealing with that kind of thing, I mean,
we try not to be. You know what I did in the very beginning? I did have to ask. Okay, wait a minute. You, not me. I was in this longer than you. I've been acting longer than you have. Wait a minute. You, not me. But I got over it. You know.
No, I love you so much.
I'm like, get over it, girl. Let's just move on.
Girl.